Have you heard of the new AMD Ryzen processors that are coming out soon? You probably have. Lots of people have. It's big news. It's huge, huge news. But this video is going to be about why I am just a little bit skeptical about the Ryzen processor. So before I start this, I'm just going to make a quick little disclaimer that I do not know that much about computers, okay? I am not anything like Linus Tech Tips, alright? This is really just why I personally am skeptical based on my own experiences with my own computer and my personal thoughts on this whole thing. So to start things off, I have in my computer an AMD A6 5400K APU. Now, when I bought this computer, the box that I got it in said that it was a quad-core processor. Okay, I got this computer a few years ago. At that time, I really didn't know anything about processors or anything about computers at all. All I knew is that generally, the higher the number, the better it is. You know, the faster, the better, the more, the better, that kind of thing, right? So when I saw quad-core, I'm like, oh, okay, this is a pretty darn good computer then. It's going to be a pretty good processor. Well, at that time, I had no way of knowing whether it was actually a quad-core processor or whether it was actually a dual-core processor. So I found out about a year ago when I was talking to someone, I think on a comment in my on one of my YouTube videos here, that this processor is actually a dual-core processor and it does not have a quad-core model. So of course I was a little bit upset because I paid for a quad-core processor, or so I thought, and I actually got a dual-core processor. Well, you know, at the time, it didn't seem like it was that big of a deal to me because I could still do most of the things I wanted to do. Well, now, since I've been on YouTube longer and doing more and I've learned more things and been trying new things, I've been doing a lot more and I've been getting more ideas and I want to do a lot more things, but I can't because I'm limited by the hardware of my computer, which is totally fine. That's not what this video is about. So in the past even just single year and a half or so, I have learned a lot more about computers. I've been doing a lot more research and stuff because I want to get the best of the best. That's something pretty much anyone would want, really. This past weekend, I actually found out, as you can see on my screen right here, that my computer is only utilizing a single core of this supposed dual core processor, or should I say supposed quad core processor, because that's what it originally was in terms of the information that I got with it and for it and all of that. So you can see here that my computer, according to Task Manager, has one core and two logical processors. Well, logical processors are not the same as cores. Logical processors have something to do with threads. I don't know all the technical stuff behind it. All I know is that threads gives you sort of more processors because it kind of cheats a single core into being treated and thought of as two cores, or something along those lines. I may not be 100% correct on that. You can let me know in the comments down below. Now, by opening up CPUZ and using this program here, which basically just gathers a bunch of information about different things on your computer, one of which including the processor. So you can see here that according to this, this processor does technically have two cores, as well as two threads. You can also see this little picture up in the top right corner here that it says A6 quad core. Ooh, interesting. Why is it saying quad core if it's actually a dual core processor? I don't really know myself. So, I have tried going into the BIOS settings and I can't find anything in there. Maybe I'm doing something wrong, but I can't find anything in there to figure out how to enable or to find out if any CPU cores have been disabled and how to enable them. But according to msconfig, there are two cores and they are both being utilized. But according to Task Manager, only one is being utilized. So that's a little bit fishy, isn't it? And in my research about this issue, I came across this little bit of information here that basically states that all AMD CPUs, not all, only some, mostly the newer ones, do not actually have the full amount of cores that they are stated, but they in fact have half. That's interesting. Now, that apparently has a lot to do with modules instead of full CPU cores, and I don't fully understand what that all means. All I know is, according to this info that I found on a forum online in my research for this, that the amount of cores are not 100% accurate. Now, if you don't know, the new AMD Ryzen processors have 8 cores. They are an octa-core processor. There are 3 different variations. There's a 1700, the 1700X, and the 1800X. And each one has slightly different variations, mostly in terms of speed, I believe. Again, correct me if I'm wrong. But all 3 of them are an octa-core processor. Now, an octa-core processor would mean that it has 8 cores. And 8 cores is going to be a lot better than 4 cores even, right? Well, it's amazing that they are offering these 8-core processors for such a low price that they are. Here in Canada, the price ends up being, for the 1800X, ends up being about $600, $650, around that kind of range. That's pretty darn good compared to a 4-core, quad-core Intel processor. Now, I know from watching Linus Tech Tips' video on the new AMD Ryzen processor that they compared the performance of the new 8-core Ryzen processor from AMD to a quad-core, 4-core Intel processor. Now, see, that's what I find a little bit strange. If you're just comparing price, you don't need to compare performance. If you're going to compare performance, you cannot really feasibly compare something that is twice as powerful to something else. If you're going to truly compare its performance, you need to compare this 8-core processor with Intel's 8-core processors. That only makes sense, because of course it's going to perform better than Intel's 4-core processors if it has 8 cores. Now, I believe the reason why they compared the new Ryzen processor to Intel's quad-core processors are because Intel's quad-cores are the general go-to processor for gamers and for general consumers, because it has really good performance for its price. But it still would make a whole lot more sense to me, at least, if they compared an 8-core with an 8-core. Because if you're comparing price, you don't need to do any kind of performance test or anything like that. So to lay it all out, my skepticisms are as follows. 1, my experiences with AMD processors has not been the greatest. Granted, I've only really had the one. But I've been gypped around twice, because the information on the box for the CPU says quad core when it's actually being marketed as a dual core, but it's actually truly only using a single core. So that's 2 little misconceptions there, and that's a little odd. My second skepticism is because they are comparing an 8-core to a 4-core, and that is strange, especially if it is true that what this info says here, that all the AMD processors have half the amount of cores as they actually advertise they do. Because then, if that's actually true, that means that this octa-core is actually a quad-core, and that's why it's being compared to another quad-core. But again, just to reiterate, these are just my own personal experiences and thoughts based on those experiences. I would have to actually try out and take a look at the new octa-core AMD Ryzen processor myself before I can really say too much more about it. So now I leave it up to you. I want to have an open discussion about this. So any thoughts you have on the new AMD Ryzen processor, or your own experiences with AMD processors, or anything else to do with this, let me know in the comments down below. And I will see you all in the next video. God bless. So to start with, I have an AMD processor in my own CPU, in my own computer.